My name is Giovanni. Giovanni Luz Fernandez.
Giovanni?
Giovanni Luz Fernandez.
Luz Fernandez.
Yeah.
You run, at the moment, you run Lorenzo's Margao.
No, I run the Quadro Art Gallery, which is the company is Lorenz Imaging.
Yeah.
We are into picture framing, bespoke picture framing, fine art printing, art hanging systems. So here, we have installed them here. Art restoration and art gallery.
But I'm interested in your grandfather and granduncle. Tell us.
My grandfather was chief sports photographer for Times of India.
Which year?
He retired in the year 1946-47. Then moved to Goa, he actually took a picture with Nehru and Gandhi, which was
very iconic. It has been written picture. About and it has been described and published.
Yes, it was
even a few years back in
in
the Herald or some paper.
There was even a stamp made out of it.
Yeah, a stamp made out of the photo.
Yes.
Gandhi and Nehru sitting together and discussing something on the floor. On the floor.
Not on the floor. They were sitting on a
stage.
No. It was It was in the Congress House. Where it was, I was told. I never made great about it, but I don't know. They were sitting on a cot.
Okay.
On a cotton.
Low bed.
And they were discussing something, and they were smiling and talking something about it.
That photo is very iconic.
Yes, you can still find it.
And what were his other memorable occasions? No pictures left from his time.
I don't have much knowledge about those pictures, what were done actually.
Maybe in the archives of the Times of India.
Possibly, yeah, exactly. Which we didn't have access to because they were the rights of the Times of India. You know. Then he set up his store in Margao as
famous Lorenz.
Yeah, Lorenz photographer was there, this thing was there, a studio in Margao.
And the top one or two or three of Salset. Of South Goa.
Yeah.
Of South Goa.
Yes, yes. Of those times.
And even till today, almost.
Yes.
You can say so.
You said grand uncle. My grand uncle's name was Costasio Fernandez. He was a sculptor, painter, and also he used to write, a poet. He has done sculptures of for many many
themes.
For many themes, for many renowned industrialists, their busts and all. He has actually sculpted.
Yeah.
Yeah. And used to work in all types of medium: cement, bronze, stone, and. This thing, what is it? Metal also.
You mentioned that the sculptures at the entrance to the Mapsa
municipal
market are his.
Yes, those are his.
As you enter the market.
Yes.
The main entrance.
Yes, main entrance. There's left and right, and when you enter on the top also, there are two sculptures. They are made in cement.
Currently painted in golden, some shade of gold.
Yes, they completely destroyed them actually.
They were originally in red.
Usually he used to do it mostly, after doing it he used to paint it red.
I see.
Yeah. In Mandavi, Hotel Mandavi, on the facade, there is a big sculpture.
Yeah.
Also was...
External one,
which is also huge.
He was active in which years now? We are talking about 50s?
I really don't know. I have a book of him and I will give you the literature which I have. Maybe you will be able to extract something.
Very
I also have a link which was written something about him on an international platform, which I will share with you, where it gives information also of Abbe Faria's statue which was here, which actually it was claimed that it was he who had done it, but not signed. He couldn't sign it or he didn't sign it or something like that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I have that information. You will have to check on it and see what it is. Then what is this? He has done the sculpture which is next to Holy Spirit Church. Paz Joseph Vaz is by him.
The small one.
Right. yes.
Center of the road.
Yeah, in the garden.
Correct.
Yes. There's also one more. I was told that in the municipal garden also there's one bust of, I don't know who it is, but there is one also made by him only. I don't know which one it is. There are a lot of paintings of portraits of many mayors, which are also
Margao? Margao?
In Margao municipality, which are there, which are inside the municipality. Which are
really?
There. Yeah. Which are here.
So there were.
So and to tell you the fact, I myself was asked to restore a portrait of Costain Company's founder.
Dr.
Azevedo.
Founder. Ivo Azevedo.
Ivo Azevedo, he was the son of the founder. So the founder's picture, which I took for restoration, when we did the restoration, we found my grand uncle's signature on it while we were taking off all that
layers.
This thing, what is that? They put varnish, wood varnish over it. And we had to restore it. While restoring, we found that signature of my uncle Costain.
Giovanni, you grew up with art and paintings and photographs all your life? From a very early age?
Yes, from my childhood. Yes, from birth.
And you studied at Loyola's or where?
Yeah, I studied at Loyola's.
Yeah, which year passing on?
I passed out in 1991.
Photography was an option or was it thrust upon you?
We used to just be around, so it just, because we were there, it just...
Osmosis. Up.
Yeah.
What further plans? Where do you plan to take it to? How can we
camera? Photography is not my... I was not associated much in photography. The more I was associated was... I was more involved in the technical part of it. Like restoration. Like picture framing. Like... what is that? Art. More related to art. So that's how I was connected. Then I got my certification done in picture framing. And there... The art journey started getting more and more into art.
Last question, how do we remember these greats from the past who are forgotten and whose work is not remembered sufficiently in Goa today?
How do we?
Yeah. Tough question because it's hard to access their work in the first place, no?
See, first of all, no artist or a photographer of that time ever realized that to ever keep anything archived, that there will be something used to it. Everybody thought that is their bread and butter, so they have to work for it and that's it.
Yeah.
Nobody kept any history or archives or stored anything for the posterity. I mean, it was all done, Baba, this is my money, I will just earn from it.
Bread and butter
bread
issues.
And
yeah.
Nobody thought that
it would have value one day.
Yes.
And the greatness of it all.
Even today, if I'm working with so many artists.
Yeah.
People till today they don't value the people's art so much unless he becomes renowned based on connects or some great person buys his art, that becomes high value person. But no artist becomes great now. But the day that person cannot paint due to some, maybe an injury or he's no more, that art...
Scarcity.
That becomes...
Valuable.
Valuable art. And anybody is ready to pay for it.
Thank you.
At any cost.
Thank
so
you so much.
So I feel
much.
Yeah. We should inculcate that people should store their whatever works, document any of their works. If these photographs, to keep the photographs, so that they can be archives of the future.
Thank you so much for those insights. Yeah.